CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Marshall. The night is filled with a million stars, said the poet. How does he know? Has he counted them? We raise the question not to embarrass the bard, but in the interest of accuracy. Because there are more than a million stars. Why, there are more stars than anyone could ever imagine, let alone count. And if each star is a sun, more or less like ours, and has planets revolving around it, more or less like ours, doesn't it stand to reason that out there somewhere, there may be people more or less like us?
Doctor, he comes from a planet somewhere.
He does?
Yeah, they're looking for a place to colonize.
They are?
Like the explorers came here from Europe hundreds of years ago. And they're gonna take over.
How do you know?
He told me. Doctor, he told me.
Uh-huh. You get a good night's sleep.
But I'm not crazy. Don't treat me like I'm crazy.
Well, don't force me to.
Our mystery drama, Identified Flying Objects, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Bryna Raeburn. It is sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and Sign-Off, the sinus medicines. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Identified flying objects, visitors from outer space. Yes, the curiosity is piqued, the imagination is fired. Creatures from other worlds, can they come here? Will they come here? Perhaps they are here already. Do they mean us good or ill? I don't know, but I can tell you this. If a flying saucer were to land at high noon on the busiest intersection of the city, here is what would probably happen.
What's that crazy looking thing supposed to be? Gotta be a publicity.
What do you say, Johnny? Let's move it, huh?
Come on, move it. Look, Johnny, I'm talking to you. Don't you understand English? You're blocking traffic, okay? So just move this heap, whatever it is, right out of there.
How'd you like to vore e a mana to the judge?
Who's the arresting officer?
Patrolman Maxwell Pinchot, Traffic Z, Your Honor.
What kind of a summons is this, officer? You don't designate the year, the make, the model of the car?
Your Honor, I could not determine that information.
What kind of an answer is that, officer? All these facts are clearly stated in the registration.
He don't have any registration.
What? What kind of a case have we got here? A man is arrested for blocking traffic. To begin with, we don't know what kind of a car it is. Secondly,
Excuse me, Your Honor, but I wouldn't exactly swear it was a car.
You wouldn't exactly swear it was a car? Well, what kind of vehicle was he using to block traffic? A truck?
No, Your Honor. I would say it looked more like a flying saucer.
A what?
A flying saucer.
Officer Pinchot, are you a well man?
Oh, yes, Your Honor.
Mentally?
I believe so.
You know, and I know, there's no such thing as a flying saucer, isn't that a fact?
It is.
Well, then how could that vehicle be a flying saucer?
Oh, I didn't say it was a flying saucer, Your Honor. I said it looked like a flying saucer.
Very well, let's begin all over. What's the defendant's name?
He wouldn't tell me his name.
What kind of an answer is that? His name has to be on his driver's license.
Oh, he don't have a driver's license.
What kind of... Who is the defendant?
It's him, Your Honor.
Well, now, what kind of way is that for him to dress? What kind of courtroom do we have here where a man can come waltzing in wearing his nightgown? What's your name?
He won't answer that, Your Honor.
Please remain silent, officer, and give him a chance to answer. What's your name?
Vur E. Amana.
There you are. That's his name. Vur E. Amana. All right, Mr. Amana. Now we're getting somewhere. Where do you live?
Vur E. Amana.
What have you got to say for yourself?
Vur E. Amana.
Yes, yes, we know that. We've been there. Now we have to move on. Now let's have your story.
Vur E. Amana.
You speak English?
Vur E. Amana.
Well, do you speak any other language?
Vur E. Amana.
Let's get some interpreters up here.
Habla español.
Sprechen Sie Deutsch? Parlez-vous français?
Bring my broski.
What kind of case is this? What is this? A courtroom of the United Nations. Impound the vehicle, whatever it happens to be, and remand the accused for psychiatric observation.
And now, the news. Still, the lead item is the story, or more accurately, the non-story, of Vur E. Amana. Is he a visitor from another planet? Is that saucer-shaped thing actually a spaceship? As you know, there has been a tight curtain of security wrapped around this entire affair, but now the wraps will be removed, partially at any rate. With me in this studio is an official of the FIA, Colonel Alonzo Hawke. Colonel, what is your opinion concerning Vur E. Amana?
We're not even sure that's his name.
But we understand he keeps repeating those words.
Oh, yes, he does.
Well, if it's not his name, sir, what is the significance of those words, the sounds?
We are virtually certain they are significant, although it's possible that they may not be.
Yes. Now, the materials of the spaceship.
The alleged spaceship?
Yes. We understand that they are made of elements that can be found here on Earth. Iron, copper, magnesium, and so on.
Yes.
Then shouldn't this prove that the vehicle does not come from outer space?
No.
No.
It may only prove that the same or similar elements may exist on other planets.
Colonel Hawke, are you saying that we have a visitor from another world?
No.
Then what are you saying?
Nothing.
Colonel, shouldn't the absence of an engine or any other visible means of propulsion prove that the vehicle could not have traveled any great distance?
Yes, and no.
Oh.
It may use a form of energy that is unknown to us here on Earth.
Then you are saying it is from another world?
It may be. Then again, it may not be.
Well, thank you, Colonel Hawke, for being with us and providing us with a most incisive analysis.
Dr. Newdell? Yes, I'm with a patient now. I couldn't say. It's a complicated situation. Have we made any progress? Absolutely none at all. When can we expect any? I have no idea. Certainly. Anytime. Goodbye. What am I going to do with you?
Vur E. Amana.
Yes, yes, I know. Well, now let's try this. You see, this is a board. Huh? A board. In it, there are holes. You see? Holes. Some of the holes are round, like this, you see? And some are square. Square, like this, you see?
Vur E. Amana.
Indeed, yes. And these are called pegs, you see? Pegs?
Vur
E. Pegs.
Vur E.
Never mind, I know the rest. At any rate, see now, look. I take a round peg and I insert it into a round hole. Then I take a square peg and insert it into a square hole, you see? Now.
Vur E. Amana.
Yes, yes. But Vur E. Amana is not the issue. Now, Go ahead. See if you can fit the pegs into the holes.
For I amana.
Dear, you could be from another planet. So you should be intelligent enough to pick up some of our language or teach us yours. Can you say anything else but vur I amana?
Vur I amana.
This could all be some sort of publicity stunt. But what?
Vur I amana.
On the other hand, it's entirely possible that you're just a nut. A plain, simple, common, ordinary nut.
Vur I amana.
All right, yes. We'll try again tomorrow. Although I wish I knew just what it is we're going to try.
Vur I amana.
Yes. Well, we'll try again tomorrow. We'll try something.
Oh, excuse me, Dr. Newdell. I thought you'd be finished in here.
I am, Molly. I suppose I am.
Well, I can come back and clean up later.
Oh, it's all right, it's all right. I was about to leave.
Oh, well, how is he, Doctor?
I wish I knew.
Is he really from some other place?
Molly, your guess is as good as mine.
You gotta admit, he keeps the room clean.
Yes, he does.
He ain't as messy as some. He don't give me no trouble.
No, well, good night, Molly. See you tomorrow.
Good night, Doctor. So, how you doing today?
Vur I amana.
Yeah, and vur I amana to you. And listen, just between you and me, what's your angle, huh? I mean, what are you scheming to...
Vur I amana.
Look, we heard that before a million times.
Vur I amana.
All right, don't get excited.
Vur.
Okay, vur. So, what are you trying to tell me?
Vur I amana.
Take it easy. Calm down.
Amana.
Look, they got straitjackets, padded cells, bathtubs full of ice. Now, you don't want any of that.
Vur.
Just sit down, huh? No, don't try to say anything. Let me get you a drink of water. Just sit there quiet. That's it. Now, don't you feel so much better?
Well, how are things at the nut house today, Molly?
Oh, I don't think that's a nice name for it.
Oh, okay. How about funny folk?
Oh, look, Pops, it's just a place for a lot of poor, unfortunate people.
Yeah, and you're one of them.
Yeah, pass me some soup.
Who are you going to meet working in a place like that, huh?
Pops, I'm 43 years old. Who'd I ever meet anywhere?
Oh, soft-pedal that over 40 bit. Now, you can still pass for 35, Molly.
Look, what other job could I get, huh? I never had a chance to go to school.
You could take a secretarial course.
Yeah, and get a job pounding a typewriter? I can make as much at the hospital, and it's got a good pension.
A pension? Hey, you're starting to talk like an old lady.
Well, some women are going to have to go through life alone. I'm one of them.
Isn't fair. You can make such a great wife for some guy.
You know something? I'm just beat.
Hey, you didn't finish your supper.
I'm not hungry.
Hey, you sure you okay, Molly?
Yeah. I don't know. It's just that I'm so sleepy all of a sudden.
You don't look so good.
Something's come over me. I need some sleep.
Hey, should have called a doctor?
No. Just... help me into bed. Oh, yeah, Mama. Yes. Oh, my head. What's happening in my head? It's going around. The electricity sparks.
Molly, wake up now. You're having a nightmare, honey. Molly.
Yes.
Molly, get up. Molly. Molly, you okay? You're screaming, Molly. Molly, what is it?
My head. It feels bigger. Doesn't it look bigger?
No.
But it must be. There's so many things in it. So many things that were never in it before.
Molly, should I take you to a doctor?
No.
But Molly, honey.
Oh, Molly.
Wait.
That's what that nut, the one who was in what was supposed to be a flying saucer, kept saying, isn't it?
Vor Iamana, Ivora, Vuna, Anailura.
What are you saying? Molly, what are you saying?
What is she saying? What does it mean? What language is it anyway? And how did she learn it? Those are all good questions, and they all have good answers. We shall give you all the pertinent details when I return shortly with Act Two. Speculates about the stars and dreams and wonders just as we do. Will we ever know?
Molly, what were you saying? What kind of language?
Nothing.
Yeah, but I heard you.
I was just dreaming.
No. This was after you woke up.
Was it?
Yeah.
But you know how it is. Sometimes you can look like you're awake, but you're really still asleep.
No, you said this thing that sounds like what that nutter or whoever from the flying saucer kept saying.
I did?
Yeah, plus some other gibberish.
Oh, Pops, I can't imagine what you're talking about.
Molly.
Hmm?
Molly, you don't have to tell me if you don't want to, but I'm scared.
Yeah. Yeah, so am I.
What does it mean?
I don't know. But there's one way to find out.
Oh, good morning, Molly.
Morning, Dr. Newdell.
Well, isn't this early for you?
Early?
Aren't you supposed to come in around noon?
Oh, well, I don't have very much else to do, Doctor.
You're a very devoted person, Molly. But I'm afraid you're working too hard. You don't look well.
Well, I feel fine. Honest.
As long as you're here, spend a little time with Vor Iamana, you know, the one from outer space. Or maybe he isn't either.
Oh, all right, sir.
He seems to like you. That is, he always smiles when you come into the room.
Oh, sure, Doctor.
Who knows? Maybe you can find a way to reach him.
Yeah, but I don't know anything about, you know, therapy.
Uh-huh. Sometimes it's better that way.
Vor Iamana.
Vor Iamana. I am the conqueror.
Vor I Ivora.
Vor I Ivora. I am from Ivora.
Vuna Aina Ildura.
Vuna Aina Ildura. We rule the universe.
I have reached you. Of all the minds on this entire planet, I have reached yours.
What language are we talking?
Ivora, the most beautiful of all the tongues in the universe.
Ivora.
I am Mor-El, and you are Molly. What does Molly mean?
What does it mean?
Every name must have a meaning.
I don't know. I guess it just means Molly.
My name, Mor-El, means the king's son.
You're the son of a king?
Yes.
Oh, well, what are you doing here?
You see, I wear the blue robe. It is the color for the reconnaissance scout.
Oh.
I search the universe for a planet for Ivora to conquer and colonize. And I have found one.
You mean ours?
Yes.
Well, what's going to happen to us, the people who live here?
I suppose you'll have to be destroyed.
Just like that?
That's what happens all the time, doesn't it?
What are you talking about?
History.
What do you know about history?
I know all about your history.
You do?
I've been studying it.
How?
You see, I can reach into a person's mind, and I can see everything he knows.
Oh.
So, all the while Dr. Nudell has been talking to me, I've been picking his brain. I know everything he knows about history. On your planet, men killed off animals at first. Then stronger groups of men killed off weaker groups and took their land, didn't they?
Well,
So we conquerors from Ivora will not be doing anything strange or unusual, will we?
You're going to kill all of us?
I'm sorry. And it isn't because we hate you. Ivorans don't hate anyone. It is against our religion.
Well, if you're so smart and so strong, why do you let yourself be kept here in this place like a prisoner?
I could leave here any time I chose.
You could?
Yes. I could transport myself to my spaceship and just take off for Ivora.
But why are you telling me all this?
Because I have to have someone to talk to.
How do you know I won't tell everybody about your plans?
That really doesn't matter.
Now look, you're only one person. They could stop you.
At this stage of things, I suppose they could.
Then why did you tell me? You know I'll tell the doctor, the police.
Yes, well, maybe I know something you don't.
What?
You'll have to find that out for yourself.
You see, Doctor, what he's trying to tell you is that he's the conqueror.
You've been speaking to him?
Yes, sir. I know the language.
You do?
Yes, he comes from a planet somewhere called Ivora.
Ivora?
That's right. And they're looking for a place to colonize. I guess it's like the people from Europe came here hundreds of years ago.
Continue.
And they're going to take over.
Take over?
You could say like we did from the Indians.
This is what he told you?
Yes. Well, we have to do something about it.
Do something?
Yes, because if we don't, the people from Ivora, they'll come here and kill us all. I thought I'd better tell you, Doctor.
Yes, yes. I'm glad you did.
You don't believe I'm telling you the truth, do you?
I believe you're telling me what you think is the truth.
Oh.
Molly, you've been working very hard, too hard.
You think I'm crazy, is that it?
Well, I think you're overtired and overworked.
But it's the truth. I spoke to him.
I can arrange to get you some time off, with pay.
Oh. Yeah. I see where this is going.
Molly, it happens to all of us. It even happens sometimes to me.
What happens?
You spend so much time with unbalanced people that now and then you sort of go off the deep end yourself.
And that's what you think is happening to me?
Well, you know I like you. I wouldn't lie to you.
Then how do you explain the fact that I can speak Ivoran?
Ivoran?
The language of Ivora. I know I speak it perfectly. Better than I speak English.
No,
I never even went to high school. I had to go to work. I don't know very much in English. But in Ivoran, I know everything. I speak so beautifully. I say things that sound so smart. The prettiest words roll around in my head. Vur I linana, I am the queen. Vur I lailalea, I am queen of beauty and delight. Where would I ever get to think things like that?
I'll look into this thing.
Yeah, sure.
I mean it.
Doctor, I work here. I know how you talk to the other crazies.
I still think you should take a little time off.
Let's go. Move that heap.
Oh, are you Officer Pinchot?
Maxwell Pinchot, that's me.
Well, could I talk to you?
What do you want to know?
You remember the person who you arrested because he was in that flying saucer?
I wish I had it to do all over again. I'd have looked the other way.
Well, he's dangerous.
Yeah?
I have to tell this to somebody. And you're a cop. He's the advanced scout from a place called Ivora. They're going to kill each and every one of us.
Is that a fact?
Yes, he told me.
He didn't tell me.
Well, that's because he couldn't communicate with you.
And he can communicate with you?
Oh, please, believe me. Do something about it. You're a policeman.
Now, lady, don't you worry about a thing. I'll do something. Believe me, I will.
Oh, you don't believe me. I can tell. You won't do a thing. Sir, Your Honor, Judge.
Mm-hmm. What?
I'm sorry to disturb you at your dinner, but I must talk to you. It's a matter of life and death. Please listen.
What is this?
Well, it's that man. You know, the flying saucer person.
What are you talking about?
The one who keeps saying, Vur I Amana. That means, I am the conqueror. He's going to take over the earth. We have to stop him.
What kind of a restaurant is this where a man can't even have his dinner without being disturbed?
Your Honor, it's true. Every word is true.
What kind of entertainment are they putting on? What kind of an act have you got there, madam?
It isn't an act. Oh, you don't believe me. No one believes me.
You have to quit that job.
All right, Pops. Let me alone.
You know, Dr. Newdell called up. Now, you're under a terrible strain.
I am. And it's your fault.
My fault?
Your fault, the doctor's fault, the police. Everyone laughed at me. Nobody wants to believe me. Nobody.
Honey, because it's such a crazy story.
Well, does that mean it isn't true?
Now, what you need is some rest.
Rest? We're all going to rest forever. We're all going to be killed.
Molly.
Why don't people believe me? Everyone treats me like I'm some kind of nut.
Okay, Molly, maybe you're right. But there's nothing that you as an individual, as one single solitary person, can do about it. You have to face it.
I'm facing it.
Good. Now, you have to accept it.
No, that's the one thing I won't do. I won't accept it.
Well, what are you going to do?
I don't know. I'll think of something.
You've had a difficult time.
Oh, I sure did.
I told you there is something you would have to find out for yourself.
I sure did.
Nobody believes the prophet of doom. Your people, they don't want to stop me and Ivora from taking over the earth.
That's because they don't know any better. But I do.
And therefore, you have decided to stop me.
How did you know?
And it's true, isn't it?
Yes.
You're going to kill me.
I have to kill you.
They won't believe the reason. You know that.
I know that.
You'll spend the rest of your life in an insane asylum.
Oh, I'd be doing that anyhow. So, I got myself a gun.
A gun?
This one, here.
I see. You're going to kill me.
Oh, it's nothing personal. It isn't because I hate you. I don't hate anyone. But I have to kill you. That's all.
Murder. If it's to be done at all, perhaps it's best if it's done reluctantly. Yes, it doesn't change anything. And it doesn't really do the victim any material good. But at least it gives the thing a certain sense of style. Well, this is only the end of Act Two. Just the right point to kill off a major character. Will it happen? We'll know that shortly when I return with Act Three. They say, if you want to make sure a thing is well done, then do it yourself. Of course, murder is another story. Or is it? When you think how cheaply life is held in some quarters, when you consider how many people are killed carelessly, needlessly, it's rather easy to ask, what's one more life? Yes, it's easy to ask, but so hard to answer.
Well, go ahead. Kill me.
That's exactly what I'm going to do.
I understand. That's a very primitive-looking weapon. How does it work?
I don't know. All I have to do is aim at you and pull the trigger. and the bullet comes out and kills you.
Whatever it is, get it over with.
I will.
So? What's your problem?
A problem?
Why don't you activate that weapon?
I don't know.
You don't know.
I should kill you. Oh,
there's no doubt of that.
But somehow I just can't do it.
You can't.
The thought of taking a human life.
But don't you understand? The fate of your world and everyone in it is at stake.
I know.
Something is wrong with me.
What?
Ever since I landed on this planet, I've been... I have no word for it in Ivora.
A cough?
Yes, cough. It's an ugly word for an ugly feeling. Why, what is it? I think I'd better activate my mental computer.
Your what?
Here, you call it the brain.
Oh.
That's because you don't use it very much, but I'll get all the facts on this thing, this cough.
Oh, it's no big deal. Practically everybody around here coughs.
What's that?
That? Boy, everybody knows what that is.
What is it?
Are you kidding? It's a sneeze.
It's a sneeze?
Hmm.
Why does it happen?
Well, it could mean you're coming down with something.
Coming down with something?
Like an illness.
Illness?
Or there's some kind of irritation in the air.
Oh, I have a great deal of work for the computer. I can see that. Cough, sneeze, illness, irritation.
What am I standing here like a dummy for? Why don't I kill you?
Well, it would seem to be the smart thing to do. I know you have what we would call moral considerations, but you really should do it.
Why are you telling me that?
Because I like you.
You like me?
Tell me. I don't know how these things are on Earth, but are you still of childbearing age?
What kind of question?
I have to know. I am Morel, a crown prince. I would have to have an heir to the throne. No, but what's the use? I'll never be king.
Look, just hold on a minute. I don't follow all this.
You would have to come back with me.
Back where?
Home. To Ivora.
Well, what makes you think I would?
It's in your mind. You're thinking about it.
I'm thinking no such thing.
Well, you're not aware that you're thinking it. Why do you suppose you don't want to kill me?
Well, I'm not the kind of...
You can tell yourself that. But you know it isn't true. Why do you think I stay here? Well, two reasons. First, I'm learning all about this Earth. And second, I see you all the time.
There's nothing special about me.
There's nothing special about me either.
Oh, how can you say that?
It's true.
Nothing special about you. Why, you can travel through space. You can read people's minds. There isn't a single person on this Earth who could even come close to you.
Yes, I may be far and away the smartest person on planet Earth, but back home in Ivora, I guess I'm just the dumbest.
Oh, I can't believe it.
When I was born, there was great rejoicing because there would now be an heir to the throne. Why do I do this? What is the word?
Cough. No, it's nothing. Almost everybody on Earth coughs. So you were telling me when you were born there was great rejoicing or something.
It didn't last.
Oh, why not?
Because it soon became obvious that I was very stupid.
Oh, I listen to the things you say. You're brilliant.
For Ivora, I'm stupid. And everybody knew it. No, you can't keep a thing like that secret, you know.
What happened?
They decided to make me a reconnaissance scout for outer space exploration.
Well, you can't be stupid and do that.
But don't you see, the whole thing is a fake.
I don't understand.
There never was such a thing as outer space exploration. They created the operation just for me.
But I don't know what...
It was to give me something to do. Something harmless. And also to get rid of me.
Are you telling me the truth?
Oh, if you could read my mind, you'd know it's the truth. Outer space exploration.
For what? Didn't you say to look for other planets to colonize?
But there are no other planets fit for human habitation besides Ivora. Everyone knows that.
There's this place, Earth.
Yes, and I found it. It proves they were wrong. Oh, how positive they were. All the experts, all the scientists. There is no other planet in this or any other universe that has the proper temperature, terrain, water, carbon, oxygen, atmosphere to sustain human life as we know it.
Oh, they believed that?
They still believe it. According to their calculations, they can prove no other suitable planet exists.
But you found one.
I know, but they don't believe me.
How can they not believe you?
Because you don't know. Oh, you don't know.
What don't I know?
How stupid they think I am. I'll prove it. I'll call the base. I'll open my mind and let you listen. Just stand still. Why do I do that?
I told you, it's because...
I'm waiting for the computer and then I'll get a complete analysis. Now, I'm calling the base. You must stand perfectly still. Close your eyes. Try to think of nothing, and you will hear.
Hear what?
This is Morel, calling the base at Ivora. Calling the base at Ivora.
Base at Ivora. Come in, Morel.
I have great news. I have landed on a planet suitable for colonization. Yes. Proper atmosphere, suitable terrain, acceptable climate.
Is that a fact?
Yes.
Prince Morel, how long have you been out in space on this tour?
5 years.
It's possible you have contracted a kind of illness known as space illusion.
But I'm telling you, I have found...
I am sure you think you have.
But it is true.
You've been out in space too long. You're suffering from space illusion. You must return for a computer adjustment. Order from the base. And sign off.
There. You see?
How can they be so mean?
This is what I've had to put up with all my life. Will you help me?
Well, help you do what?
Come back with me.
Where?
To Ivora. When they see you, they know that I'm right.
But then they'll come back here and kill everybody.
Oh. We'll make better use of this planet than you will.
That doesn't give you the right to take it.
I know you'll come with me. I see it in your mind. You want to come.
No.
It's your only chance to know love. And it's my only chance, too. Back home, no other girl would look at me.
Well, I like that.
Yes. You'll come with me. I'm calling the base. Base? Morel calling the base.
Morel, what is it this time?
You can stop patronizing me. I'm coming back with proof. Proof. Morel out. There. I told them. Oh, what a triumphal entry we shall make. The crown prince and his consort. Why do I do that? Wait. My computer is about to speak.
What are you talking about?
Quiet. It reports that sneezes and coughs are phenomenon caused by the polluted air and water of the planet. Although originally it's a pure atmosphere, it is now completely overloaded with sulfides, methane, ammonia, hydro and fluorocarbons, among a host of other noxious and poisonous substances. That's enough. I don't want to know anymore.
More air. What's the matter?
Oh, the whole thing has collapsed. I said I found a planet we could colonize. I went on record. I challenged the base. And now, it isn't true.
It isn't?
Now I know why I cough and sneeze. You heard the computer. Soon, this place will be too poisonous for life. Now... I can't go home.
I thought I'd find you here, Molly. Molly, I thought about what you told me. I believe you.
You believe me?
Yes. The way you put that vocabulary together, now you're not a linguist, and yet it follows basic laws of language.
But I don't...
You could be right. And so I spoke with Colonel Hawk of the FIA. They want to hear more.
Well...
If you are right about Morel here, or whatever his name is, being the advance scout for an invading alien army...
Yes, if I am right.
Well, I'm a doctor. I don't want to think about it. But I also live on this planet. I have a responsibility.
Will they have to kill him?
I don't know. This whole business, it's out of our hands. We'll have to do what's best, whatever it is.
Then you must go home, Morel. If you stay here, they'll kill you.
I don't care.
I care.
You care?
I care. And I'll go back with you.
You will?
Yes. You can read it in my mind, can't you?
I can read that you want to do it. But that doesn't mean you will do it.
I will. Now, how can we go back?
Get me a suit of clothes, can you?
Yes.
No one will know me if I'm dressed like everyone else.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know the vehicle is in a place called the impounded lot. I can see it. There's a tag on it that says release on payment of $50. Do you have $50?
Yes.
Then we can go.
Well, you see how easy it is? Oh, how brilliant you are.
No. No. I can't go back.
Why?
Why? When I get back, I'll be the laughingstock of the entire planet.
But I don't care. You'll be alive.
But you have no idea how dumb I am. I am just not smart.
Oh, well, you no longer have to be concerned about that.
I don't?
No. From now on, you don't have to be smart. You know why? Because you're gonna have a smart wife.
Maybe that's the great secret. Maybe a smart wife is all it takes. Anyhow, we don't know how things worked out when they got to Ivora because we weren't there. But if we ever do get the facts, we'll be glad to fill you in with another story at another time. I shall return shortly. To believe that the whole business is a matter of packaging. Consider, if some half-mad, half-literate, well, we might as well even say half-wit, were to come staggering into some remote hamlet and swear that he had seen a flying saucer, why, on the basis of his completely unsupported statement, millions would believe him. On the other hand, if a flying saucer were to land on the busiest intersection of the city, it might not even draw a passing comment. Our cast included Bryna Raeburn, Earl Hammond, Gilbert Mack, and Cork Benson. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
Something so mysterious about those men.
Oh, yes, mysterious. That's the word. Oh, I'll never forget their faces. I can tell you that.
Yes, especially the second man. If you know the phrase that comes to my mind, you know what the phrase is?
The walking death.
Yes. His face was more transparent than white. Like a face of impure wax.
Oh, ooh. What a strange feeling has come over me. Like a chill.
Yes, I think a breath of air is what we need now.
Oh, yes. I'll second that. Those two men down there have knocked the stuffing out of me. I can't imagine why.
What did you call the second man? The one who was chasing the first?
You mean the way he looked?
Yeah, I remember. The walking death.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by True Value Hardware Stores. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.